So we will finalize the numerical integration with the Simpson's rule. So Simpson's rule, named after Thomas Simpson, although it is used by Kepler a century before, so again it was a way to approximate integrals without having to deal with lots of narrow rectangles. Now we are not dealing with rectangles, we will be dealing quadratic curves. So its strength is that all the rectangles and trapezoids works better for linear functions. For if you have a linear function and if you want to take the integral of a linear function, you can use trapezoid rule easily. But for Simpson's rule, it works quite well if you have curve. Okay? So this is the strength of a Simpson's rule. So how Simpson's rule is working? Here you go. So for the trapezoid rule, what we were doing, we were approximating with linear lines, right? But for the Simpson's rule, for each 3 point, we are approximating a quadratic function. For each 3 point, look at that. 1, 2, 3, we are approximating this. For the other 3, we are approximating this. For the other 3, we are approximating with this function. And we are dealing with the integral of it. So how can we derive it? So let's say that we have a function ax squared plus bx plus c. This function is passing through minus hy0, 0y1, hy2, let's say that. And if this function is passing through, which means that these points are on this function, which means that when x is minus h, y should be y0. So this is our function, y is y0, x is minus h. So I'm getting this equation, right? If I plugged in this point into my function, this is what I'm getting. And if I plug 0y1, which means that when x is 0, this is 0, this is 0, y should be y1. So y1 equals c, it's coming from this point. And this third equation is coming from hy2. When x is h, y is y2. Okay, we have these three equations. Now, between those three equations, let's observe that. What is y0 plus 4y1 plus y2? y0 plus 4y1 plus y2 is 2ah squared plus 6c. Now, why did we find? Keep this one in my mind. Keep this one in your mind. It's in our pocket, okay? This relation is equals to that one. Now, let's take the integral of the same function from minus h to h. So, integral of a quadratic function from minus h to h, since this is just a polynomial function, ax cubed over 3, bx squared over 3, cx from minus h to h. Plugged in h, minus plugged in minus h, this is what you will get. And if you factor out h over 3, what do you get? 2ah squared plus 6c. So this is exactly what we found in here. So instead of this expression, I am writing y0 plus 4y1 plus y2. Exactly. So the area of a quadratic function under between minus h and h is exactly equal to that one. H over 3, y0 plus 4y1 plus y2. What is y0? y0 is the value at the first point, y1 is the second point, y2 is the third point. So this is y0, this is y1, this is y2. So this is true for the first quadratic function, first 3 points. Now, if you have more than 3, which you will have in general, you need to sum them up. So y0, y1, y2, we have that one. And after that, y2, y3, y4, we have that one. And y4, y5, y6, you have that one. And it will go like that. And if you check that, we have y0 here, y4, y1 here. Look at that, there is 1y2 here, 1y2 there. So if you sum them up by factoring out delta x over 3, you will have 2y2. Then 4y3 and another y4 is going to come here, 2y4 and 4y5 and y6 is going to come again twice. As you can see, only the first and the last expressions are alone, which they have 1 as coefficient. And after that, the intervals are going like 4, 2, 4, 2 coefficients, okay? Remember that. This is how Simpson's rules are working, okay? And this is just one example for just 3 points. Let's say we have a function f of x and we are taking an integral over 2, 12. And let's take the midpoint. 7 is the midpoint between 2 and 12. So we have 3 points. What we were doing, the expression was delta x over 3, right? Delta x is b minus a over 2. That's why we have b minus a over 2 over 3, which is 6. B minus a over 6, fa. Since we have only 1 point interval, it will 4. If you had more than that, you should go like 2, 4, 2, 4. And the last one is coming alone. F of 2, F7, F12. What you need to do is just write the values of it and you can find the approximate integral between 2 and 12 like that. Okay? This is just one simple example. And if you check that, the errors, trapezoid and midpoint rules have errors of order delta x squared and Simpson says delta x to the 4. So Simpsons are working very well most of the time. And even if in MATLAB there is a built-in function, quad FAB, f is just an inline function, a and b are the boundaries. And this quad function is also using some way of Simpson's rule, okay? Adaptive Simpson's rule. It's just changing the interval size according to the curve you have. So MATLAB built-in function is also working like you need to define an inline function and you can call this one as quad f01, which means that it will take the integral of this function from 0 to 1, okay? And this quad function is also using Simpson's rule we just talked about.